Thank you so much for tuning in to this third and final New Music New Haven concert of the fall semester. I'm Aaron J. Kernis, director of the series. This event features large ensemble works by Linda Dalamore and Marco Adrian Ramos, as well as chamber music by Julian Fuego Gonzalez, Suman Kim, Eli Greenho, and also Linda Dalamore. I want to give special thanks to the recording and production team, without whom the magic that you see could not have possibly happened during this very difficult time during the pandemic. Most especially, Matthew Lefebvre, Benjamin Schwartz, and Henry Birdsey. And enjoy the show.
Hello, I am Marco Adrian Ramos, composer of Incate for String Ensemble. The title of the work is a command meaning kneel down, and the music unfolds as a series of variations on the severe and assertive material presented at the outset. These elements are freely manipulated and reconfigured to form these sort of self-contained islands of music whose relationships or lack thereof are a matter of interpretation for the listener. After the opening section, the first variation space presents a solo quartet against a blurry, dreamlike background. The second is stark and sober, but skitters away quietly. The third is the slowest, a sort of romantic adagio with the scent of rotting meat. The fourth is an attempt to recapture the opening, and is briefly successful before transforming into the harsh light and endless hammering that abruptly ends the piece. My infinite thanks to my colleagues Joe Larangis and the intrepid musicians in the ensemble, and again to Professor Kernis and all of the staff and crew that make New Music in New Haven happen in these times where new art and ideas are sorely needed. Thank you.
Thank you. Hi, I am Julián Fueyo, and I am the composer of the next piece in the program titled Projections No. 1. This piece is the first in a collection of pieces for piano solo that I am writing, which explore the refraction, reflection, and projections in the topological sense of sonorities and other specific musical ideas. This piece in particular explores the polyphonic approach to these ideas of refraction, reflection, and projection. This is most obvious in the series of canons and imitation passages throughout the piece, which, for example, begins in monophony and ends in a three-voice canon. That being said, I really hope you enjoy the performance put by Simon Karakulidi and the rest of the amazing program.
Inside is a sinfonietta for 15 players. It was mainly written during the first semester of my MMA studies here at Yale, which coincided with the birth of my son, Charlie. When I was writing the piece, I had a live performance in mind, which was cancelled due to the pandemic. So what you're about to hear has been recorded in phases, with the strings, percussion, and piano recorded in one session, and the winds and brass recorded individually and overlaid. Big thanks to the Yale audio production team, in particular Henry Birdsey, for their support and skill in creating the recording in this unusual way. The conductor of the ensemble is Ryan Tani, and I'm really grateful for his work here too. Enjoy!
Thank you. Hi everyone, my name is Soomin Kim and I'm a second year composition student here at the YSM. The next piece you'll hear is called the Eighth Song and it's for three violas. Starting with simple triads, it goes through various musical styles including a fugue. All the different sections are based on one musical theme which I took from a famous video game that my friends and I like to play. I'd like to thank my amazing performers, Chris Rogers Beadle, Rose Nellis, and Harris Bernstein for giving so much to this music and bringing it to life. Thank you for tuning in and I hope you enjoy the eighth song. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Eli Greenhow. I'm a composer, a songwriter, and a guitarist from Brooklyn, New York. I'm currently doing my doctorate degree in music at the Yale School of Music. The piece you're about to hear is a movement of a larger string quartet, which deals with loops and knots and tangles, and the morphology of those things, both physical and also sort of metaphysical. This particular movement, entitled Loops B Catches, deals with the notion of a loop that must loop itself to death a loop that is forced to change through repetition, that breaks after a certain element is thrown in that causes it to shift. In the piece, material sort of swirls in on itself until the force of its own evolution causes it to become something else, at which point it sort of elides with the next section, and the process repeats over again in a varied way. It was a really fun piece to write, and it was an extremely rewarding rehearsal process. I was so lucky to get to work with an incredible quartet, so thank you to all the members of that quartet. And I also want to thank the incredible production team at YSM for doing a great job recording and editing this video. And also thank you to Aaron Kernis, who was a wonderful teacher to me throughout the course of this writing process. So I really appreciate it. Anyway, I really hope that you enjoy the piece. See you on the other side.
Thank you.
Ascension is in two movements, chorale and madrigal, for alto, flute and viola. The creation of this piece was supported by Creative New Zealand and commissioned and premiered by Ensemble Klanggrauschen based in Kiel, Germany. The musicians, Elizabeth Farrell and Marie Yamanaka, were wonderful Zoom collaborators during the process of composing, particularly for the first movement, which is in an octatonic, multiphonic chorale. The theme the ensemble gave me for this piece was extremes, and you might find it sitting on the edge somehow. Thanks for listening.
Thank you.